one is tensile stress, another is tensile and what it is called, shear stress. So at a time two stresses are generated, so and both have different directions. So what about T? Does it have zero direction or it has two directions? It has two directions, one for tensile, another for shear stress. So T is not a scalar, it is a tensor. Tensor means which has either two directions or more than two directions. So, and it depends upon rank of tensor. Now, like it has two directions, it is of rank 2. Vector normally have one direction. So, vector is tensor of rank 1. Scalar has no direction. So, scalar can be said as tensor of 0 rank. Are you getting my point? Akumi, any question? No. Vector, tensor of rank 1. It means it has one direction. If it has one direction, it will have three components. Okay? Assuming I am talking about Cartesian coordinates, x, y, and z. What about dyad? Dyad means it is tensor of rank 2. And how it will be represented? It will be represented as u, v. It has two directions. So if it has two directions, it will have nine components. I can explain here. You can look. This is a dyad. If this will be clear, then I hope tensors will be clear. Say this is having two directions. So this is vector time vector. This tensor is known as dyad. Suppose u equals to u1 I cap, u2 j cap, u3 k cap. V is v1 I cap, v2 j cap, v3 k cap.
I'll change another.
If I put both together, what will be the components? If I keep them together, the components will start like u1 v1 ii plus u1 v2 ij plus u1 v3 I K U2 V1 J I so on. So you can check there are nine components. If there are two directions in a tensor, it will have nine components. Simply calculation 3 square. For one direction we need I J K, three components. For two directions we need 3 square. So what about triad? Triad will be represented like U V W. I think components you know 3q, that is 27. And if a tensor is having rank n, how many components will be there? 3 to power n. I think you are getting the concept. If you want to discuss something, because if tensor will be clear, I can go deep into my paper. Because tensor is a basic problem to understand.
I have a question about what's the meaning of I.
Yeah, that's a good question. Only if I say about I, J, K, these are the unit vectors. This is not a vector. This is called unit dyad. Unit dyad. But it doesn't mean, it doesn't have to anything about unit vectors. For triad, it will be I, I, J, K. So the terminology of, if you see some tensors, its terminology goes like that. A, I, J, K. Triad vector. The unit triad vector. Unit triad. Okay?
So how do you visualize the tensor?
As I told you, something which has, like, very, I'm not talking in terms of technically. If I point out a direction, it is a vector. If I point out like this, this combination is not a vector because it has two directions. It's a tensor.
So you're, if you have a tensor, how do you visualize it? How to draw it?
It's difficult to draw because I didn't think about that thing. But if I talk about mu, the theory which I read in that point, suppose this is a material which is not isotropic. At this point, if B is directing this direction, H is in this direction, so mu is represented like this. So what you will say? BH.
So now you're saying that a vector cannot be represented as a tensor. Is that what you're saying?
No. All tensors of rank 1 are vectors. So tensor is a general term. Tensor is a general term. If I will say tensor of rank 0, it means it has 0 direction, scalar. Tensor of rank 1, 1 direction, vector. Tensor of rank 2, dyad. Tensor of rank 3, triad. --. But I have two questions. Can you read the last two lines? Can you please? My question is, if tensor of rank 0, it is a scalar, that's for sure. But do all scalars are tensors?
Like with the previous example, right?
Yes.
Is it the magnitude? I mean, in that particular direction, or what does it actually imply?
Look, the thing is that if we, for example, if I ask you, what is A? The answer will be vector. Yes or no? If I will say, what is this? There is no dot here. What you will say? This is a dyad. Dyad means tensor. Dyad means tensor of rank 2. If I say, what is this? You will say, this is a tensor of rank 3 or triad. So this is vector. This is representation of dyad or tensor 2. This is representation of dyad or triad.
But what is the actual magnitude of, how do you calculate the magnitude of a dyad or a triad?
Sure. Because ultimately they are having some direction and magnitude. Suppose I told you U is U1 I cap and so on. Okay, B equals to B1 I cap, B2 J cap and B3 K cap. So UV is represented as U1 V1 I cap, so on. Okay, now they call it mu11, the next they call it mu12, mu13. So tensor is represented as a matrices mu11, mu12, mu13. I'm talking about dyad which has 9 components mu21, mu22, mu23.
So usually also in like these II, they disappear. You're trying to get the values, it's like you're getting a scalar.
So why this is not I dot I mu.
Oh, okay.
This is I.